Dave and Jimmy with 21 Pilots, who have been touring for 21 years. After they wrap, I mean, we talked to them backstage, and they're going to take like a weekend off, and then they're off to Europe and big, humongous festivals. Just two of them. You hear 21 Pilots, you go, it must be a lot of them. Nope, it's just Tyler and Josh, and there they go. So this is backstage. Kind of quiet, too. Jimmy started by asking, some of your fans go really hard. I mean, like waiting out for days and weeks before a show like yours. What's up with that?
I live right by the venue here, and I've seen the people camped out for seriously over a week.
Really?
I walk by them every night. And
are they doing okay?
They look kind of homeless, but I think they're okay. I'm
just worried about, like, on the floor during exactly a concert. Why. They'll pass out.
Seriously? Is there such, and I ask a lot of artists mid-tour, is there such a thing as touring shape where you find yourself in a groove and it's okay? Does it take a while?
We did, like, we were in South America, so we were flying all the time, and that throws you off because you kind of, once you start to get used to, like, being on a bus and going to bed at the same time in the same, like, place, constantly change, but.
I don't know if you've ever been to a theme park with roller coasters all day, but then you sleep that night. And when you're laying down, you can feel it.
Yeah.
So now when we get off tour, we're going to sleep in our own beds that we've been wishing for all year long. And then when we get there, we're going to feel the bus, and it's going to it's gonna psych us out. Yeah. So,
You guys are playing the All-Star game up in Cleveland. You're playing the festival, right?
Yeah.
Will you get some like really cool All-Star jerseys or anything?
We better.
Yeah,
what's the coolest thing like that you've got? Like, you got to play somewhere or throw out a first pitch or – you know, a football game or something, you got like some really cool swag with your name on or anything.
Yeah, we get the jersey thing of the local team. Sometimes
Denver
it's
arena.
Yeah, like in Orlando, if it's like the Orlando Magic, you know, a really nice like NBA version of it. But then you play some places that have their own like triple, quadruple A version of a team, and you're like, oh, I got the Mud Daubers jersey.
And you sport it proudly.
And then if you're in a local, sometimes I'll play basketball here locally, but you have to have a jersey, and it's just a rec league with my brothers. I kind of feel weird about wearing a jersey with 2-1 on it with my own name on the back. Like, I'm, like, super proud of myself.
I once went shopping with a Dave and Jimmy shirt, and I felt really whack. All right, okay, I've been holding back actual music questions. All right.
Oh, we don't like
for just a moment. Tell me how Jumpsuit became epic, because the first time I heard it, I was like, this song was made to make 60,000 people stand up and rock their fists.
Yeah, we always thought that a first song on a record, a new record, would be a great way to open up your show. I mean, I don't know why that's a philosophy we've bought into from the beginning. So we knew that that first song, we should put ourselves there. What does it feel like to open up a show? What song do we wish we had when we're opening this show?
I have a non-music question because I don't know music questions.
You're listening to a weekend interview with Tyler and Josh of 21 Pilots.
But last time we talked to you guys, we talked about the whole underwear thing, and you said you got to try Saks underwear. You got to try. You turned me on to it. That was like a year ago probably, right? And I probably have 40 pair now.
No, really?
I swear.
And he's talked about it 40 times.
No, it's awesome. I'm wearing them right now. You probably are too. And
I'm all compartmentalized.
Me too. I feel great. And the cool thing
is Tupperware for your nuts.
Yes, exactly. And I'm wearing, I think, I don't know what I got, a Christmas thing?
I don't want to
thing.
See you.
A Christmas. Yeah, I got like the snowball thing. Here. They send me free underwear.
Did they?
Yeah.
They're like that.
I know. I mean, you can't probably get into that too much. They're going to want you to be on a billboard, but I can take all the free underwear.
They did ask about that. No, like a modeling thing. I was like, there's no way.
Oh,
like,
they said
Kevin Love did it. I was like, I don't care.
They saw me. I didn't get that same offer.
Okay, now a change of, I don't have any underwear questions. Right. One of your albums has been on the Billboard 200 for 4 years.
I can confirm it, and I feel like 200 is a really large number.
In other words, I've done the quick math in my head. Things gotta be good.
Yeah, no, it's, we actually, I'm assuming you're talking about financially.
We call
those bags.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. The bags have, I guess, all of a sudden happened in our lives. But we've always given this philosophy of trying to put back into the show. So when you see the show, there's so much, I mean, we know how much each light costs per week. And it's because we're putting a lot of money back into that show.
Is there a moment where you realize, like, hey, I mean, unless I get a gambling addiction, we're all right.
There is a, yeah, I mean, there is something that very cool about the idea of, you know, my kids or my, you know, kids' kids. Like, what kind of, they call it generational wealth. Like, it is a cool feeling. It's something that neither of us grew up feeling at all. You know, none of our family members ever felt that before. And so it is.
Do they bug you about that? Like, hey, you're doing all right.
Yeah, every once in a while.
Like, you know, our close family members.
We bought our parents' houses.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah,
they're fine. They take care of themselves, and they don't like really ask or need anything. But it is fun. Yeah, buying them houses is one of the coolest things.
Tyler and Josh of 21 Pilots. If you know the band, that was cool. If not, you're saying there were 19 other pilots. What the hell, Dave and Jimmy? This is Dave and Jimmy.